Should we finish with this one last card trick?
Go on then.
Okay. It takes a couple of minutes to set up this, but we can do it.
Magicians don't normally have this part where they're checking their cards and rigging everything.
Yeah, I know. Take any old number. Let's take a 6-digit number. Doesn't really matter what it is. Okay. We're interested in multiples of 7, right? Okay. 7's are the hard one. So you need to tell your audience how hard 7s are, checking divisibilities by 7s.
Unless Norrie's in the audience.
Unless Norrie's in the audience and he starts to feel warmth, and then you just kick Norrie out. Okay. So is this number divisible? So we've come up with a number here, randomly selected. Is it divisible by 7? I'm hoping not. We want a number that's not divisible by 7. So let's just check it. 4, 2, 8. Oh, it's not so annoying. It's not supposed to be. All right, well, we could rig it a bit.
Why don't you just flip one of the digits?
Yeah, we will. Okay, so this number is not divisible by 7. We know how to make it divisible by 7. We just saw. We just have to change that to an 8, right? And then it will be divisible by 7. Okay, but we're going to do something a little bit more challenging than that. So let me set it up. Okay, so I just have to set it up quickly. So let me just, you're going to need a few packs of cards to do this, actually. Memory. Oh, hang on, so that space there, so that needs to go there. Okay, so we need another pack of cards, so I'm going to use my old Liverpool cards. Okay, so we need to...
They have some full players on them, or is it just the back?
Nah, these are some ancient cards from when I was a kid. Nah, they haven't got anything on them.
God, worst card trick ever.
It does take a bit setting up. If you've got a patient audience, you can do this. I realise it's taking some time. You can fast forward, Brady. What are you complaining about?
Oh, yeah, I'm doing that. Don't worry.
Okay. Okay, so what have we set up here? It took a little bit of time to set up, I'll admit, right? Okay, but now comes the amazing part, right? Okay, so you've got your original number, and what we've done is we've created a bunch of rows where we've removed the number in each, one digit in each case. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to put a card in each position so that each row is a multiple of 7. And remember, this is really hard because multiples of 7s are hard to spot. Okay, so let's do it. Well, we know the first one, right? Because we already, and you need to know the first one to do this trick. You need to know the first one. So we know that that needs to be an 8. Okay, so we know that that needs to be an 8. Okay, so now I'm just going to go through and I'm going to put some cards down and I'm going to make each row a multiple of 7. Okay. So first one, so I'm pretty sure I need to put a 4 there. Okay, so the next one, that has to be a 7. Okay, the next one has to be a 2. Now, by the way, I warn you, I've done this a few times at home and I've got it wrong more often than not. Okay, so this is a bit of a lottery. Okay, so the next one is... it's easy. What am I talking about? Okay, so this goes like that's got to be a 3. And then finally, the very last one of all is going to be... a 7, I think. Okay, so did I get it right? This is definitely not guaranteed for me, because my arithmetic is so lame. But let's check it. Well, we know the first one's going to be a multiple of 7, right? Because we've already done that one. Okay, so let's check all the others. Okay, I would love it if this works. Okay, 3, 5, 1, 4, 4, 9 divided by 7. Yes, that's a multiple of 7. Good, that worked. Divided by 7. Yes, that worked. 4, 2, 9 divided by 7. Yes! Oh, we're doing well, Brady, we're doing well. 4, 2, 9 divided by 7 equals, yes! And last one, did we do it? 7, 5, 1, 4, 2, 9 divided by 7. Yes! I got them all right, okay?
What was the algorithm you were doing?
So it's pretty quick though. Do you admit, even though my slightly lame banter arithmetic at the end, pretty quick, because these are multiples of 7, they're the hardest. I am not Norrie. Right? Thank God. Right. Okay. Okay, so what's the algorithm, right? Obviously, it's an algorithm that I'm using here. Okay, so the thing that you have to do is, let me just show you how you do it on the first one, right? So you needed to know this card. So you need to know that. But you can set that up at the start. You know, what's the, you know, you generate a multiple of 7 and add a bit. Okay, so you always know this card. Okay, so once you know this card, you're in business. Okay, so now you look at this number here, this two-digit number here. Okay, in this case, it's 28. Now you divide that two-digit number, whatever it is, by 7. And you ask, what is the remainder? Okay, in this case, well, the remainder is 0. Okay, if I divide 28 by 7, of course, it works exactly. So the remainder will be 0. So then you've got to generate, so the card you have to put there is the thing that will make this number here have the same remainder. Okay, so of course, that had to be a 4 because 49 has remainder 0 when I divide by 7. And then you proceed for the next one in exactly the same way. You look at this one, 44. Okay, you ask, what is the remainder when I divide by 7? Well, in this case, the remainder is 2 when I divide by 7. So you ask yourself, well, what number do I need to put here to make sure this has remainder 2? Well, that's a 7. And you carry on like that. And if your mental arithmetic is better than mine, you can make this do this super fast, right? Without knowing anything about all these big numbers. You just do this little simple test each stage. Also very easy to prove. And actually, you can apply that test to any number as well. It'll work for any, you don't just have to do it for 7s. If you wanted to do multiples of 9s, for example, you could do the same test, okay? Of course, you would then ask, what's the remainder when I divide by 9? And you would do it like that. But of course, because 7s is the hardest of the single digit rules, then that's we do it for 7s. Okay, so that's, I don't know, is it the best trick in the world? Okay.
It's all right.
It's all right what you've got to set up. You could, I mean, because you don't have to do it with cards, you could just do it with a little, like here, basically. This is me messing about with it. This is probably wrong. It's probably one example where I got it wrong, actually. I don't know, I can't remember. Okay, and that's it.
Cool. 13, what would you have done?
Okay, so 13, I need to put 12 cards on top of that, and 12 is 1, 9, 1, 3, and no units, so I'm going to put that on the top, the middle, the middle.
As in a card game or in a casino, the cards were turned up one at a time, and somebody tried to guess what they were.